All right, round two. I'm on the draw with a good hand. On turn one, I got hit by a Monastery Swift Spear off of a Steam Vents, which is interesting. So we'll see how this match plays out. I could see some certain deck lists where I'd want to just path the turn one Swift Spear, but until I have more information, I'm going to save the path and just play out my creatures. So maybe this is like a fast blue-red Delver deck. Maybe it's some kind of combo-ish, like Kiln Fiend, maybe Niv-Magus Elemental type of deck. Looks like just a fast blue-red Delver. I mean, if you're vapor snagging my one-drop creature, things are... Either if you're vapor snagging my one drop creature, either you have an insane hand or you're going to be in trouble. If I draw an untapped land on turn three, it'll be pretty good to catch me up on the board and catch me up in terms of life total. If I don't, then I can at least just play a tapped land and hold up Path to Exile so nothing terrible happens to me. Top with the Serum Visions, okay. Wow. Well, that's not that bad because I was going to have a mana go to waste next turn anyway. So now I can go Soul Warden, Path, Windbrisk Heights and feel pretty good about that turn. Though I don't feel great about taking 8 damage here when my opponent just scryed to the top. I think I should stick with the plan. I can even path on my own turn to mess up my opponent's scry. It's pretty reasonable. Yeah, okay. So let's say we path to exile one right now. My opponent is searching, so the two scry cards are gone. That could, you know, could be good, but now things are just up to the mercy of the top of my opponent's library. So if my opponent just attacks, I don't think I can block. Like, yeah, I'm dead to double lightning bolt, but I think I need the Soul Warden in play in order to claw back into the game. Suspend Rift Bolt. So why would you suspend Rift Bolt instead of hard casting it? Maybe because you have a remand, a counterspell. Well, if I had drawn an expensive spell, it was going to be tough to know whether I should just slam the Spectral Procession into a possible remand, but now that I have 2-1 drops, I think it's pretty clear that I should just play my 2-1 drops. Could be a Snapcaster Mage also, Snapcaster Lightning Bolt or something. But I guess not now that the Soul Warden resolved. And should I just attack for one with Soul Warden? I think probably I should. I'm not gonna, hopefully not gonna jump block. If anything, I'll just block with Sarah Ascendant. Which, yeah, that's probably a good play. So the Rift Bolt straight at me. It's a tough way to do it against the Soul Sisters deck is to try to burn somebody out. Now I'll block. The Sarah Ascendant's really not doing much on the table. I'm not going to get to 30 life in this game unless I've won anyway. And I don't want to be dead to a Lightning Bolt, so jump block, get a life out of the deal. Not too bad. Now I think I cast Ranger of Eos. Right. Okay, so that's according to plan. And I'm not going to attack. I don't know exactly what could happen that would make me block the Swift Spear, but I don't think I stand to gain much by getting in a point of damage or two. So hypothetically, if my opponent went like Gitaxian Probe, Gitaxian Probe, Gitaxian Probe, Gitaxian Probe, you know, and then shed a 4/5 Swift Spear, I would want to chump block it. Two cards in hand. I think I have to take it. Again, dead to two burn spells, but Soul Wardens are pretty valuable to have in play. No. Okay. Please don't have a second one. I'm so close to clawing back into this game. Wow, unbelievable. So I would have to say the top of the library was pretty good to my opponent after shuffling away those two scry cards. Maybe I should have blocked, I don't know. Well, this should be a very good matchup for me. I refuse to lose the match. I'm even surprised to have lost one game to a deck like this, just because I have so much life gain and should be able to win creature battles. Well, the Forge Tender is definitely coming in. Thalia also seems pretty good. Canonist decent against Snapcaster Mage, which my opponent assuredly has. And then what comes out? Probably my more expensive spells. Sometimes I cut like one Horizon Canopy in a matchup like this. Sarah Ascendant's pretty bad because it's, you really, like, things have to be going so well for it to do anything. And if I'm bringing in Thalia, I could see cutting some of my non-creature cards. Well, all right, so let's say these are my options. I get to play 10 of these cards. If I don't have Ranger of Eos in my deck, I'm not going to have Sarah Ascendant in my deck. So I'd say at most I'm going to have one Ascendant. Honor of the Pure. Against an opponent that's burning my creatures. I guess Honor of the Pure is just good to have in case of stuff like Forked Bolt and Electrolyze. And Spectral Procession is pretty good. Alright, how about a configuration like this? Definitely playing first. This hand's good. Oriok Champion ought to be quite good in this matchup, although my opponent did have Vapor Snag, but it takes a really good draw for the Vapor Snags to really do much. Forge Tender, I guess. Delver is probably one of the best cards against me. Reveals the Bloodstained Mire. It's pretty funny. Sure. It was a good draw. So lay out some protection from red creatures. Not going to save me from a flipped Delver, but it's a good start. Okay. Ooh, Storm Chaser Mage. So note that I can prevent the damage from the mage if it ever gets to be, you know, like a 4-5, or I just need a little bit of breathing room. Nice draw. Now I can make the Pride Mate a 4-4 out of Lightning Bolt range. And then I probably can just swing with both these creatures. Think if my opponent trades off the Delvers, he or she's just going to have basically no way to win. And if, I guess if trade off, Vapor Snag, the Pride Me, nah. Yeah, this is fine, I think. I'm happy to trade. It's possible that I should attack with the Forge Tender, but not the Oriok Champion. Interesting. So, trading the Forge Tender, does that maybe mean my opponent has like a board sweeper or wants to use two burn spells to kill the Pride Mate or something? Vapor Snag. Okay, so that's certainly step one for my opponent to get back in this. So three cards, two of which are Bloodstained Mire and Vapor Snag. So the Steam Fence was played untapped that turn, which that has to mean Snapcaster Mage, right? There's like nothing else. Electrolyze. Well, I'm going to cast the Pride Mate. I don't really see anything else that I can do. What my opponent should do if he or she has Snapcaster is cast the Snapcaster in response to Pride Mate, target Lightning Bolt, and then bolt before the triggers go off. Snapcaster Vapor Snag. I don't think this is as good a play as Snapcaster Lightning Bolt would have been. But it's, yeah, I mean, it's probably the best card my opponent could have. And then I wonder, will he or she want to trade with Oriok Champion? Probably should. Yeah, I mean, certainly should. So my opponent will block Oriok Champion, will target Vapor Snag, block Oriok Champion, go to the end step. Well, my opponent misclicked, targeted the Lightning Bolt after already tapping out on red mana. It's too bad. My opponent said something in the chat about internet not going well for him. Well, now with that misclick, the Pride Mate's just going to go crazy, and it's going to be game over. I think maybe I should cut all of my Archangels for game three. It's just too slow against Mana Leak and Vapor Snag. I'm going to be on the draw. I'll probably bring back in the Ranger of Eos. Cut the Archmage or the Archangel. Just basically try to have as many cheap cards in my deck as I can. I guess the Rangers are good with the Forge Tenders too. That was kind of lame that game was decided by a misclick. But we're on to game three here at any rate. I'm going to cut the Archangels, bring back the Rangers. I still don't think I need to have even one Serra Ascendant in my deck because any game where I'm at 30 in the mid game, I think I'm just going to win anyway. And I can get like two Forge Tenders or Soul Warden Forge Tender. The Rangers are going to be powerful enough as is. Yeah, I'll stick with the Thalia as the Canonist. If my opponent has a land light draw, Thalia can just be so good. Yep. Opponent's actually down to 5 minutes on the clock. Between, I guess, internet lagging and took like 8 minutes to show up before the match started. Now who knows how this will end. I hope we get to play the whole game. I mean, it's kind of a cool matchup. It'll be lame if it game two ends with a misclick and game three ends because of the clock. And each second that passes without my opponent doing anything seems more and more likely that I'm just going to win on time. But, I mean, a fast, delver type of draw can still win in 3 minutes. In 2 minutes, I'm not sure. I don't know that there are many draws that can win in 2 minutes. Another like 20 seconds, and I'm ready to call this one. But we got 1.5 interesting games out of this match. Like, game one was really close and interesting. Game two was kind of close and interesting until my opponent misclicked. And then it looks like we're not going to get a game three, really. So I think game two, my opponent. If my opponent had done the Snapcaster Lightning Bolt to kill the Pridemate play, because I just had a Plains in my hand, my opponent probably would have been a little ahead in that game. If my opponent had done the Snapcaster End of Turn Vapor Snag play, I think I would have been a little ahead just because, the board was pretty even, but I would have had the Pridemate in my hand, and any creature that I draw makes things go pretty well for me. But with the misclick, I mean, the game was essentially over. Like, maybe my opponent could have continued playing to try to draw a Vapor Snag or another Snapcaster. But basically the writing was on the wall. Well, unfortunately, it looks like we're not going to get any game three. So I'm going to stop the video here, and I will be back for the finals of this 8-man tournament.